Yes, today we will study about the types of map. Basically, there are three types of maps. Yes, students, if audible, then give thumbs up. Students, give thumbs up if audible. Screen sharing is visible now. Mridul, just give me thumbs up. Screen sharing is visible. Mridul, skill sharing is visible. Okay, students, the types of maps. There are basically three types of maps. They are physical map, political map, and thematic map. Physical map shows about the physical features such as mountains, rivers, lakes, seas, forests, and farms. It also gives about the which rivers are flowing, their location, mountains, their location. The political map. Political map shows about the countries, capital cities, important towns, and important places. The thematic map. Thematic maps are the map that shows about certain themes or topics such as rainfall, crops, industries, etc. So these were the main three types of map, student. Now the example of physical map. You can see the location of Himalayas, the Thar Desert, the Bay of Bengal Sea, Arabian Sea, Indian Ocean in the southern part. In Rajasthan, we have Aravali Mountain Range. Then we have Vindhya Ranges in the central part of India, Satpura Mountain Range, Chota Nagpur Plateau, important rivers as Ganga, Yamuna, Brahmaputra. So these all things are shown in the physical map of India. Now the next is political map. Political map gives us the description about the countries, capitals, and towns of India. Next is about the economical map. Economical map shows about the natural resources or economic activity that are dominant, and geographers use symbols to show the location of natural resources or economic activities. Students, economic activities means which are related to earn the money, that are called as economic activities, and the map related to them are called economic map. Means the work related to earn money, they can be industrial development also, mines, how to take out the minerals. See, yesterday I explained about that in a corner, a key legend is given. So in this you can see index of coal, lignite, petroleum. These all are showing that these things are shown in the above map. You can see for coal, different symbol is used. For lignite, red triangle is used. For petroleum, small squares are used. So these are the symbols which are used in the map to describe the particular thing, students. Now about the meteorological map. Meteorological map means the map which are used to show about the weather, climatic condition of a place are called as meteorological maps. This map shows that climate, weather condition, wind, and meteorologists, oceanographers, geographers, city planners, and many other professionals depend on these maps to record and forecast the weather of a particular place. Cartographers use colors to show different climate or precipitation zones. Students, you know what is cartographers? Cartographers means the person who make a map is called cartographer. And cartography means the art of making map is called cartography. Students, it's clear. Again, I'll repeat. Cartographer means the person who makes a map is called as cartographer. And the art of making map is called cartography. Now, this is the transport map. Transport map means the map which shows the highways or the roads, airports, railway tracks, cities and other important points of interest on the map. The maps are to plan trips and for driving directions. Yes, when we move to some other places, we carry a pocket maps which shows the road maps, road direction. If we are traveling by car, then we carry the road maps. It gives us direction in which direction we have to move. So students, this was about the different types of maps. Now the scale. Scale is very important part in explaining about the maps, because without scale we cannot understand the actual distance on the map. Scale is one of the main component to show. It is also scale tell us about the distance on the map. This distance relationship is accepted between the distance between the points on the map and the corresponding distance between the same two points on the ground. The decision of the choice of scale lies purely with the cartographer. Cartographer means the person who makes a map. Scale is dependent on amount of information depicted. If it is a small scale map, less amount of information will be shown. If it is a large scale map, more details can be shown on the map. Yes. For example, see small scale map. If small scale means, for example, we are talking about our own state Rajasthan. We have small map means we can take the map is of India and we want that information about Rajasthan. So it will not give us detailed explanation about the Rajasthan. But for the same, we should take the map of Rajasthan instead of India. And if we take the map of Rajasthan, then it will give us detailed explanation about the Rajasthan. So it depends upon the scale of map which gives us information. Now, a scale can be represented in the following three